Dear friends, as we await the festival of Christmas, let us prepare ourselves so that we may understand its deeper meaning. Let us hear in lessons from Holy Scripture how the prophets of Israel foretold that God would visit and redeem his people. In these challenging times when nations and peoples are divided and families isolated, let us rejoice in the words and music that remind us that God is with us and we are not alone. As we recall the themes of Christmas, we affirm God's good intention for all people and his unconditional love for all creation. And I'm very pleased that tonight, if you look around, we have people who have 2 feet and we also have people who have 4 feet. And not the donkeys, but there's a dear little dog here somewhere. Has anyone seen a little dog? Anyone see a little dog? I saw one on the way in, perhaps it's escaped. First, let us pray for the world which God so loves, for those who have not heard the good news of God or who do not believe it, for those who walk in darkness and the shadow of death, and for the church in this place and throughout the world, that it may always show forth the light and the love of God. These prayers and praises let us humbly offer to God in the words that Jesus himself gave us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us in the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. I'd like to stand as we sing, O come, Emmanuel.
prophet proclaims good news to a people in exile. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. For darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness the peoples. But the Lord will rise upon you, and his glory will appear over you. Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
promises to send his people a righteous king. The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will raise up for David a righteous branch, and he shall reign as king and deal wisely, and shall execute justice and righteousness in the land. In his days Judah will be saved, and Israel will live in safety. And this is the name by which he will be called: the Lord is our righteousness. Thanks be to God.
God promises the king will come in peace. Rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion. Shout aloud, O daughter of Jerusalem. Lo, your king comes to you. Triumphant and victorious is he, humble and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. He will cut off the chariot from Ephraim and the war horse from Jerusalem, and the battle bow shall be cut off. And he will command peace to the nations. His dominion shall be from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
promises his servant will bring peace and righteousness. Here is my servant whom I uphold, my chosen, in whom my soul delights. I've put my spirit upon him. He will bring forth justice to the nations. He will not cry or lift up his voice or make it heard in the street. A bruised reed he will not break, and a dimly burning wick he will not quench. He will faithfully bring forth justice. He will not grow faint or be crushed until he has established justice in the earth. Thanks be to God.
The prophet foretells the glory of the kingdom of God. The wilderness and the dry land shall be glad. The desert shall rejoice and blossom. Like the crocus, it shall blossom abundantly and rejoice with joy and singing. The glory of Lebanon shall be given to it, the majesty of Carmel and Sharon. They shall see the glory of the Lord, the majesty of our God. Strengthen the weak hands and make firm the feeble knees. Say to those who are of a fearful heart, be strong, do not fear. Here is your God. He will come and save you. Then the eyes of the blind shall be opened and the ears of the deaf unstopped. Then the lame shall leap like a deer, and the tongue of the speechless sing for joy. For the waters shall break forth in the wilderness and streams in the desert. The burning sand shall become a pool and the thirsty ground springs of water. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
The angel Gabriel greets the Blessed Virgin Mary. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favoured one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and wondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favour with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. Thanks be to God. John the Baptist proclaims the coming Messiah. John the Baptizer appeared in the wilderness, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And people from the whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem were going out to him and were baptized by him in the river Jordan, confessing their sins. John proclaimed, "The one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop down and untie the thong of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." Thanks be to God.
Seated for the prayers. Giving thanks for music, for poets, for composers, for all those who use art and our senses to remind us of the coming of Christ. Faithful God, whose promises stand unshaken through all generations, renew us in hope that we may be awake and alert, watching for the glorious return of Jesus Christ, our Saviour, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God for ever and ever. Amen. Lord God, you are ever among us. Open our eyes to your presence, that your church may be true to its mission, that we may proclaim your goodness, show forth your glory, and walk in your light all our days, through Christ our Lord. Amen. So giving thanks for all those who assist others in this time with a small act of kindness that make the world of difference, for your children who have grown old. We give thanks for the children in this season, all who remind us of your loving kindness and the sense of wonder at waiting in expectation. and praying for all God's children in this country. God of the Southern Sea and all these islands, and of all who dwell in our land, we give you thanks and praise for our country and for what we have achieved together. Increase our trust in one another, strengthen our quest for justice, and bring us to unity and a common purpose. Make us of one mind, and we pray this prayer through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ make us worthy of a place in his kingdom. May God the Son, coming among us in power, reveal you in our midst the promise of his glory. May God the Holy Spirit make us steadfast in faith, joyful in hope, and constant in love. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon us and remain with us and those we love and those for whom we pray as we wait in the season of Advent. Now and always. Amen. seated for just a moment. It says dismissal, Avi, means we're all going to be leaving in just a moment. But I would like to thank you for coming tonight. This is the beginning of Advent, which is actually the beginning of the church's new year. So I should wish you happy new year, shouldn't I, really? We're the only ones that know. But Advent is all about waiting and looking forward. And for the children who are here, you might notice that the decorations aren't red and green and gold. They're actually violet or purple, and that's the colour for waiting, for waiting. And it must be, so when we're younger, it must be very hard to wait. And so we're thinking about waiting for the good things that are before us. And at St. Matthew's, I can tell you that this year can be very challenging for some people, and so that we at St. Matthew's are entirely committed to helping people wait in the happiest way they can. So sometimes, oh, there we are. That's a message for me. I'm off. To remember that for some people this period can be very challenging. So for emergency accommodation, for food, for clothing, sometimes we help people into rehabilitation. It can be a very tough time, and so also to keep in the places that they have as well, when they might well lose their accommodation. We're helping all those people. So it's not just beautiful music, folks, but I think it's also a beautiful message, the way that God waits with us as well, and none of us are ever alone. So thank you very much indeed for being part of that message, and for our lovely choir and our organist, our music department, and our sanctuary team. I think we should give them a little round of applause, don't you? Thank you very much indeed. And for those who are even younger than we are, you'll notice that across here, on this side of the church, there are a couple of doors, and as Christmas approaches, they're going to be going, and a couple of donkeys will be in there. And just down here near this pulpit here, which was originally in Westminster Abbey, the place where so many kings and queens have been crowned in England, that there'll be a little enclosure there with lambs. And we think about the way that God came to us in great simplicity, in a stable and with a baby born and laid in a manger. So we're going to be transforming this part of the church into a stable. So that's very exciting. It has been challenging at times. Not everyone loves farm animals. I remember some people who came in and said, "Oh, what's that?" Well, you know, it smells a bit like a farm at times, but anyway, it's part of the real experience. So please do see if you can throw yourself into the joy of the season. And for the children, I think they'll find things very much even more exciting as you think about Christmas coming up. There we are. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord, ready to meet him when he comes in glory. In the name of Christ, amen.